Hi Lizzie. I have just come from a visit to the Museum of Bad Art. It's really amazing.
Oh wow.
Tell me about it.
MoBA is a community-based, non-profit institution dedicated to the collection, preservation and celebration of bad art in all its form and glory. It all started when founder Scott Wilson showed a painting called Lucy in the Field of Flowers he had recovered from trash to his friends, who then suggested him to start a collection, and later after its success it was converted into a museum.
Museum of Bad Art has numerous pieces which have been collected over the years from various places, including garage sales and dustbins, and have been carefully curated by the museum. Collection III is concerned with the artistic representation of eyes by the artists in their own imaginative ways. The pieces range over different mediums and different creative depictions, resulting in a vibrant eye-catching collection. This includes brilliant pieces such as An Eye for an Eye, Superstar, and Eye Sees. The collection of unlikely landscapes, cityscapes, and still lifes draws inspiration from the nature and our daily life. With wonderful pieces such as the Easter Island and the Winter Monolith, this can be called one of the best collections of the museum. The pieces, made of a variety of mediums like oil, acrylic, and tempera, are so refreshing to look at that you might just forget it's supposed to be bad art. The collection of unseen forces is an unusual one, with bizarre and one-of-a-kind pieces. All these pieces have their own individual style of depicting the supernatural. Odd as these pieces might seem, they render the viewer unable to look away.
Billy Al once said, "There's no such thing as bad or good art. Art is art. If it's bad, it's something else." Art is a form of expression, creativity, and communication of feelings from the artist who is inspired by his emotions, skills, and experiences. And this very form of expression takes strength and courage. Thus, it gives no one the mandate to label something as good or bad art, and surely does not give someone the right to question someone's way of conveying their feelings. And the Museum of Bad Art helps to find a place for art that is too bad to be ignored, and reinforces the idea that there is no wrong way of doing art. When we think of a museum, images of elegant sculptures, beautiful paintings, and drawings come into our mind. But this museum is the perfect embodiment of an unconventional one, which shatters our preconceived notions of art. And this is exactly what motivated and inspired us to choose this museum. The Museum of Bad Art currently exists in the basement of a theatre and is highly underfunded. And using this platform, we would like to spread awareness about this museum and make people realize that museums help individuals celebrate what makes them unique and are able to provide a sense of community and a place to celebrate collective heritage. Thus, it is important that we all preserve our museums. Thank you.